Another 3 centimeters to the right and you would have severed your brachial artery. Auto-suture, please. And if that had happened, you would have bled to death right there in the holosuite.
The human fascination with what might have been is tiresome, Doctor. The artery is not severed and I am not dead.
Oh, well, forgive me for boring you. Let me get straight to the point. You're acting like a fool.
Your observation is noted. But spending 2 years in a Dominion prison camp is dulled by reflexes. This only proves that I need further training.
Turning off the holosuite safety protocols during a battle simulation is at best dubious. For a man with only one eye, it's positively idiotic. Now, if you would consider ocular...
I do not want an artificial eye!
Then you must accept the fact that you have a disability and stop acting
like... There are limits as to how far I will indulge you, Doctor.
General Martok, there's a priority message for you from the Klingon High Council.
We're done here.
Route the message to my quarters.
Acknowledged.
Doctor, thank you.
If you really want to thank me, don't walk in here dripping blood anymore. It takes days to get it out of the carpet.
Check it down.
Still no increase in phaser relay efficiency, sir. The throughput reading is steady at 148.7.
Have you initialized the interface program?
Yes, and then I charged the pre-fire chamber and recalibrated the emitter stage. This thing just doesn't work, sir.
Very well. We'll start over. Go to the engine room and download the operating system into the computer core, but this time do it one file at a time.
Aye, sir. Good evening, General.
Cadet.
General. I did not expect you until 2200 hours.
I must cancel our appointment. I've received new orders from the High Council. A mission of some importance. I must prepare.
Of course. May glory and honor follow you on your journey.
Excuse me, sirs. Could I just slip by?
How was the shoulder?
Oh, Dr. Bashir made the necessary repairs. I told him it was a holosuite accident. He would not understand the need to draw blood in a warrior's training exercise.
Few humans would. However, I do apologize again for the inconvenience. I did not intend to cause so much damage.
I was the one who did not parry the blow in time. A simple, foolish mistake. One that I would not have made 2 years ago.
Can you discuss the mission?
3 days ago, the battlecruiser Bemoth began a patrol along the Cardassian border. They have not been heard from since. They are now reported as missing.
It is possible she was destroyed by the Dominion. The Jem'Hadar attacked a Federation starship near the border less than a week ago.
That is our assumption as well, but we must be sure. So I have been given command of a bird of prey, the Rotaran, to conduct a search for the Bemoth. This is the first time I will have led troops in the field since my confinement by the Dominion.
It must be an exciting prospect.
I tell you, Worf, without shame, there were days in that prison camp when the thought that I would never again set foot in a Klingon vessel made me weep like an old woman.
I envy you the days ahead. It will be a glorious adventure.
An adventure that we could share, my friend. I need someone I can trust at my side. Someone whose loyalty I can count on. Worf, son of Moog, I ask you to join me on this mission. As my friend. And as my first officer.